Hello friends, welcome. So in the last lecture we have discussed how can we define animations in Android, what are the different type of animations are available in Android, and how can we implement twin animations in Android. Basically we have discussed four types of twin animations: alpha animation, translation animation, then scaling and rotation. All these four type of animations which are referred as twin animations can be applied as XML resource as well as programmatically. Okay, we have just seen how can we define this animation sequences or animations as XML resource within our application. So if we want to define animation as XML resource, then we need to create one folder anim in our RES directory, and then inside this anim folder we can define XML file. We can create an XML animation resource file which will represent one XML one animation sequence or a single animation. Okay, so let us discuss another way which is available for defining this animation, twin animations, and that is programmatically. But let me remind you, I have told you earlier that when we define animation as XML resource, it is more beneficial because we can apply that single animation to multiple views in multiple activities, multiple files. But when we define animation as in Java as programmatically, okay, we can use that animation only in the file where we have defined it. Okay, we can't use this animation which is defined in one Java file in another Java file or activity. So that is one type of, we can say, drawback while using that animation. But while on the other hand, it has benefit also that if we are going to use that animation only in one activity, then the code which we have to write using that Java language is a little bit easier and shorter than what we have to write in that XML. So both these types are advantageous as well as can be used depending on the situation. If we have to use same animation on multiple views in multiple files or different activities, then it is beneficial to define them as XML resource and put them in anim folder. Otherwise, let us see the other way, which is defining animations programmatically. So we have four twin animations, okay: alpha animation, translation, scaling and rotation. So another way is define animation programmatically in activity using Java code. So if we want to implement alpha animation, which is for controlling the transparency of an object or a view, where zero value represents fully transparent and one value represents fully opaque, the values between 0 and 1 will increase transparency in order. Okay, so the class available is alpha animation, which can be used to define alpha animation. Once we create an object of alpha animation class, so here alpha animation is a class, so to use it to define animation, we will create an object of alpha animation. Then we will set the attributes or properties of this animation using setter methods. Once we create this object, there are setter methods available which we can call to set different properties like set duration, okay, set repeat mode, set repeat count, etc. Okay, after we have set these properties, then we can start the animation using the same method, start animation, which we have used earlier while we have defined animation as XML resources. So let us take an example of alpha animation. See, I have a code, I have one layout here which has one button and image view, also a text view is there. When clicking on this button, show animation method will be called, and in this method we will animate, or in this case we will implement alpha animation on the image that is available in this image view. Okay, a boy is there. So in our main activity, what we will do, as we have just seen, we will create an object of alpha animation. Okay, we will create object of alpha animation, then new alpha animation where we have passed two arguments. Okay, the start value of this animation, that is from alpha, and the end value, that is to alpha. Okay, so 0 to 1, it means basically the object will be fully invisible, and at the end of the animation it will be fully visible or opaque. And for performing this transformation from invisible to visible, it will take 2 seconds of time. Okay, we have also set repeat mode restart alpha animation dot set repeat count. We will repeat this animation for 4 times. Then we are applying this alpha animation on text view as well as image view. I will also share the video of this practical which I will be performing while recording. Okay, right now we are just looking the how it works. Okay, how the different animations which we are just discussing while right now, how it works. So start. So invisible to visible, both things, text view and boy, both are at start of the animation, both are invisible, and after the animation ends, both are fully opaque or visible. Okay, we can give values between 0 and 1. For example, if we give a value here 0.5, then the image and the text view will be halfly visible, because 1 means fully visible, so 0.5 means half visible. Is it 4 times, not fully visible at the end of the animation? Okay, it is initial state. Okay, it comes to the initial state once the animation is over. If we want to hold the state which was at the end, okay, if we want to freeze the state which was at the end, we need to call the method alpha animation dot set fill after. It means true. What does it means? Set the view to the position or the state where it is at the end of the animation. So at the end it will be halfly opaque, and that state will be freezed for to be continued. Okay, so you can see it is not fully opaque, it is halfly opaque, means it is halfly visible, 0.5 value. Okay, now next, rotation. For applying rotation animation, we have the class available is rotation animation. Okay, so in program, let us comment these lines. In program, we need to define one object of one class. Rotation animation. Okay, very similar to the object that we have defined with alpha animation, but the values in the constructor of this different animation class will differ according to their usage. Okay, we know that rotation animation work on degrees. It needs pivot x, pivot y. It needs from degree to degree. So here we are passing starting degree 0f, it means 0 as float value, 360 as float value, ending degree. Now here we can also pass the value that pivot point 0.5x 5f, it means middle of the x, but whose x it is represented here, it is mentioned here, relative to self, it means center x of the view itself, image itself. Here there are two possibilities, either we can write to self or to parent, relative to self or relative to parent. Okay, we are using here self, it means it will be rotated from its own center. Okay, again Fifth argument is for relation of the pivot point with y axis, again relative to self, and what will be the pivot y? 0.5. So the object will be rotated from its own center. Now we are setting the duration of this animation 2 seconds. Rotation repeat mode is reverse and it is for infinite time. And here we are rotating text view dot start animation, rotate animation. Let's see, we are only applying this animation to text view. So here the text view will be rotating and it will rotate for infinite times, and the order of this repeat will be reverse. Once right to left, left to right, right to left, left to right, in that manner. Okay, so this is rotation animation. Another is scale animation. For performing scaling, we have the class available scale animation. Okay, and you know that the result of scale operation is it increase or decrease the size in both direction, width as well as height of the object. So let us comment these lines. Scale. Okay. Scale animation. So as you can see here, scale animation, object of scale animation is created. Here we have passed value. Now what does scale animation need? It needs start from x scale to x scale, from y scale to y scale, then pivot x, pivot y. Six things it requires. So here we have passed from x 1.0f, 2x 2.0, means in x direction its size should be doubled. From y is again 1.0, to y is 2.0. In y direction its size will be double. So we can say it after applying this animation, the result will be that the size of the object will be double in both direction, x and y. Okay, and here very similar to rotation operation, rotation animation, we are passing relation of the pivot point. So for x pivot point, we have passed relative to self. It means the object should be scaled from its own center. Again for y, we have passed relation, that is relative to self. So object will be scaled, but its center point will be object's itself center point. Okay, then set duration is 2 seconds, and then we are applying this animation on image view. Let's see what happens when this animation is applied. See, the object is scaled to its double size. Okay, it is scaled to its double, and this animation is performed relative to its center point, means the center point of the object remains in the center after the completion of the animation also. So the pivot x and pivot y is object's itself center. But if we want to suppose set something else, 0.7 and 0.7 again, what will happen? It will be scaled, but after scaling its location will be changed. You can see location C. Okay, it is not scaled from its center point. The center point which was earlier in the center of the screen, now it moves to somewhere else. You can see center point is now here. Right now it is here, but after, right now it is here, after scaling it moves to here. So the point which is remaining same is 0.7f. the point which is remaining same is 0.7, means 70% of the its size. Okay, Now the next type of animation is translate animation. Translate, as you know, that it translates the object locality means the location of the object changes. It can be in both direction, horizontal as well as vertical. If you want to move object only horizontal, we should change the x values, means we should consider from x to x. And if we want to only change its vertical direction or vertical location, we should apply from y to y. But if you want to move object in both directions, then we should apply all the four attributes: from x to x, from y to y. Translation, okay, translate animation. So as you can see, we have created an object of translate animation where we have passed four arguments. Okay, 50f, that is from x, 2x is 300. Okay, from y 20f, and from 2y 30f. So object will be moved in both direction. Let us apply and see. So it is moving in both direction. So it is translate animation. Okay. Moreover, we can apply more than one animation together also, sequentially or simultaneously. So here scale animation starts from here. It is scale animation. The first scale animation resize the object to its double. Again, the second scale animation following the first is resizing the object to its half size. See, here from x is 1 and 2 is 0.5. again, from y is 1, 0.5 is y. So here the first scaling will double the object to its original size, and the second animation will decrease the size of objects to its half in both direction. You can see the first animation will take 2 seconds, second animation will also take 2 seconds. But if we want to perform one after other, okay, then here in the second animation we need to set start offset of 2 seconds. So in these 2 seconds, this animation will be complete, and then after the 2 seconds are passed, this animation will be started. Yes, here what happens, see, a problem occurs here. What happens, we are applying first of all this animation on the object, okay. This animation is applied to the object, at the same time another object is created and it is also applied. So the effect of the first is overridden by the effect of second. So the effect of one cannot be viewed, is not viewed, we cannot see that because it is overridden by the second, okay. Here when we are writing that start offset 2000, that is we are just delaying the animation to start, but the program continues to execute. So the in the program, when this line is executing, okay, once it completes, next line will be executed. Once it is complete, next line will be executed. Once it is complete, this line, all the lines are executing in our program. So when this line is executed, just the second animation will start its delay, but at the same time this line will be executed. So the effect of this animation will go. So if we want to perform animation sequentially or simultaneously, okay, what I want to say is, if you remember in XML, while defining these animations in XML, we have applied more than one animation sequentially as well as simultaneously. We have used nested set. Okay, so both things can also be apply here. Here, if you want to perform. If we want to perform animations in sequence or simultaneously, there is one class available for programmatically applying this animation list. So if we want to perform that type of operation here, sorry, not it is animation set. It is animation set. Okay. So for that, we need to define one object that is animation set. How? See, here I have defined animation set object. Okay, is equal to new animation set, argument passed in the constructor is true for interpolator. Now what I am defining, one scale animation which will what we will it this operation do, it will double the size of the object, and for doing this double it will take 1 second of time. Again I am applying rotation, I am defining rotation. This rotation, what will it do? It will rotate an object from 0 to 360 degree. Again I am defining another rotation. This first rotation will take 1 second to complete this rotation. Okay, so here what will happen, both these operations are taking 1 second of time and they are not delaying. It means both this task or both these operations will perform together, scale as well as rotate. Okay, object scale as well as rotate. Now another rotation operation. Okay, it is rotating from 0 to minus 360. Again backward direction rotation, counterclockwise. Okay, it is taking delay of 1 second. It means these two operations will be performed first. After completion of these two operations, this operation will be started, which rotates in backward direction. It will take time of 1 second. And another scale of scale animation, okay, which is decreasing the size of the object to its half size. Okay, and it is also taking offset delay of 1 second, and its on duration is 1 second. So what will happen after the completion of first two animation, these two animations will again execute together. Okay, and now the animation set object which we have defined earlier, we are adding all these four animations on it. And finally, on our image view, we are starting this animation. Let's see what happens. okay, and it continues to animate because I have set one listener on it. I have add one listener on this, then that listener is animation set dot set animation listener, new animation listener. Animation listener has three methods: on start animation, on end animation, on repeat animation. On end animation, I am again calling this start animation. So once the animation is over, again it starts. Over, again it starts. Over, again it starts. Okay. So the same thing we were discussing can also be applied to these two animations also. If we think, we can apply also here. We can remove it from here. We can make this sentence to be available here, and then we will comment these lines. Okay, this line from to this line. Okay, okay, and we just want to perform these two animations. Okay, so we will here we will add these two animations to our animation set object. The name are scale animation and scale animation 1. Okay, 2 seconds. Okay, now we need to define, we need to apply this animation on our image view. Start animation. Okay, let's see what happens. See, both animations are performed. 1 point, once from 1 to it is moving to here. Power point is 7. We should change it to 5. Okay, so it will be scaled from its center. It is taking 2 seconds of time, and again it is getting back to its on position, its normal size. That is half of its size after the first animation was completed. Okay, yeah, we have not repeated this because we have not added the animation listener. We can add the animation listener also, but for that we need to uncomment these lines. Okay, we need to uncomment these lines. So we can also set repeat mode, and here nothing to be done. Okay, so this is how can we programmatically define twin animations in Android. Okay, so now next we will see the other type of animations available in Android in the next video, and for up to that, have a good day, goodbye, stay at home and stay safe.